Welcome back, everyone, to a new episode of Lusher TV.
One quick announcement. Creative Writing is looking for art and writing submissions to a new edition of Street Online. Please email submissions to street@lusherschool.org.
Also, the Spirit Week competition ends this afternoon, so good luck to all the grades. And I hope to see everyone at the homecoming game tonight, where tickets are only $3 for students and alumni.
Not that it matters, though, because the seniors are going to win. Now, we know you missed him last week, but don't worry, ladies and gents. He's back with better college tips than ever.
College tips!
With Walther.
Welcome to another week of College Tips with Walther. Today, we're going to talk about every college student's favorite appliance, the microwave.
I'm going to teach you guys how to microwave this bread.
First tip. Always cover your food.
They're just throwing stuff in the microwave, and it's ridiculous.
There are really two types of people in this world. Those that cover their food and don't make a mess, and those that say they're going to clean up after they don't cover their food, but don't, and the microwave is left messy. So always cover your food.
In the microwave for about 20 seconds.
Tip two is gonna be always put food in a container, not directly on the tray. You don't know what's been in there.
It's a very clean microwave.
It is very clean. Tip three, after you use a bowl, you've got to clean it out. After you use a cup, you have to rinse it out. After you use a plate, you have got to clean it. You can't reuse the same plate without cleaning it each time.
Oh my God!
And finally, tip four, and my most, one of my biggest pet peeves, time left on a microwave. When you're done, please clear it. And this has been College Tips with Walther.
Thanks, Mr. Walther. Now I know not to set my microwave on fire. Again.
Again?
Shh.
Sorry. You're not the only one.
Oh, I know.
Anyway, Lusher has an arts program that is second to none. And nothing exemplifies this better than our CA program.
But even the most elite students in this CA program can be taught a thing or two by our very own...
Drum roll here.
Dr. Corbett.
We bring you the very first episode of Dr. Corbett Does CA, a weekly look into our CA programs.
Ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen.
Before we get started today and we start to get through our warm-up, I just need to let you know that we're going to have a new student join us just for today. This student has never had any dance training before.
Probably I'm going to teach our dancers a few things. I would imagine with my experiences that they'll probably learn quite a bit from me.
It's a guy, which is great because we don't have any male dancers in this department at the moment, so I'm excited about that, but I need for you to set a good example and to support this dancer in every way that you can. Is that clear?
I took a college level class at Ohio State. I earned a C in that class in dance 161, and so I think those experiences are really going to support me here, and I'm hoping that I will add some value to this class today.
I think we're ready for him to come in and join us. Yeah. You might want to take your walkie-talkie.
I think so. I think I need to.
Before we get started, have you had any dance experience?
Usually, I'm in the center, when I do this kind of stuff. I just wanted to make sure that was that's okay.
Oh yeah, come on.
I mean this is fine.
This
I
just good.
Usually, yeah.
Okay.
This is level four.
This is level six, actually.
Okay, good.
Now, reach left, two, three, four, plie, five. Now we're gonna go to the right. Drop your head and walk it all the way out into a plank. And then you stay. Then you drop down, extend the arms, hands in, press up, do it again. It's just a warm up, yeah?
It's just a
warm up. Right side. Drop the left. And press it. Good. Open up the arms. Exhale.
Everybody get on the floor. Everybody.
We don't normally do this, but we're gonna skip right to choreography, if that's okay. All right, so let's come on out and learn the 3-8 count. Yeah. All right, so we're gonna, this is a little fun, like daddy combo, kind of, all right? You guys are like, so I'm starting on a diagonal. You gotta have like a little bit of attitude with this one. So you're gonna reach forward, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 5, up, 6, and a drop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Up, 6, look, 7, 8, 9.
I think I've raised the level of the class. Specifically, I think that was pretty obvious by anyone that was watching. I think if you were to go do a replay or see some of the moves that I was doing, I think they're a little advanced. And I also noticed that I was the only person in rhythm technically, and everyone else just seemed to be a little bit off. So for me, it's important that maybe everyone just kind of raises their game expectation a little bit when I'm in the room, and I'm hoping next time I'm in there, they can accomplish that. But it was a great joy. I appreciate being invited to the class. So yeah, I certainly think you'll see me dancing more in the future.
He's going like, you seen what somebody? No. He's like straight up.
With his accent. Mm-hmm. Wow, who knew a principal could have moves like that? That's a true dance prodigy right there.
Well, that's all we have for you this week, folks.
Thank you guys for watching, and stay tuned for next week's very special episode about Spirit Week.
I'm Rohan.
I'm Liz.
See you next week.